Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
As we have studied the Navier Stoke equation, we have found out the Navier Stoke equation along x direction, y direction and z direction. So now we have to consider a real life scenario in which we'll apply Navier Stoke equation and we'll calculate the solution of the Navier Stoke equation. Let us solve the exact solution of Navier Stoke. First, let us write down the Navier Stoke equation now, which says that minus of dou p by dou x, now we'll just write down along x direction, plus mu times del square u is equals to rho into du by dt. Now plus, of course, we will always have the body force per unit mass upon unit volume, so this will always be there, and we don't need to consider this force while solving this Navier Stoke equation because that is not a part of fluid mechanics which we are considering right now. So let us analyze a real life problem in which a fluid is actually flowing in the positive direction of x-axis. So it is flowing in positive direction of x-axis. Now over here there is some velocity gradient across y direction also due to the viscosity of the fluid. So now we are only considering velocity u in this entire part. So u is a function of x comma t as well as it is a function of y because u is changing with y, so x, y and t. So let us write down this part. So that means here v is equals to 0 and w is equals to 0. And secondly, we are considering over here, this has an infinite amount of length. So this length along z direction is infinite, and the change in u with respect to z over an infinite length will be 0. So the change in z will be 0. There is only change of u along x as well as y direction. So considering this part, let us expand this part and put in those values in the equation where u, v as where v, w and dou u by dou z is equals to 0. So what do we get over here? That is a minus of dou p by dou x plus mu into dou square u upon dou x square plus dou square u upon dou y square plus dou square w upon dou z square. We are just expanding this part is equals to, let us expand the right hand side also, so that will be rho times this entire part. So what do we get over here is rho into dou u by dou t plus u dou u by dou x plus v dou u by dou y plus w dou u by dou z. So this entire part we have over here. So now over here u is just a function of x, y and t. V is equals to 0, W is equals to 0. If these two things are equals to 0, then this part will tend to 0, W part will tend to 0, and we know that we have taken into consideration dou W by dou Z is equals to 0. So if dou W by dou Z is equals to 0, this part will be 0. Now if we substitute in the continuity equation, so what is continuity equation? Dou u by dou x plus dou v by dou y plus dou w by dou z is equals to 0. We already have these two terms as 0. That means dou u by dou x is also equals to 0. That means this part will be also 0. Then It is u is just a function of y and t, which we can see over here. Even over here, this part is 0. So here the x part won't be into consideration, it will be just y and t. So let us evaluate this. What do we get over here? That is minus of dou p by dou x plus mu times dou square u upon dou y square is equals to rho into dou u by dou t. Now, if the flow is a steady flow, then we know that dou u by dou t is equals to 0. That means steady flow has three conditions. It is related to velocity, viscosity, as well as density. But here viscosity, velocity will take into consideration. So that is dou u by dou t will be equals to 0. So this part also tends to 0 if it is which flow, that is a steady flow. So what do we get over here? Let us find this out. Before that, we'll just divide by density, because density is not equals to 0. So that is minus of dou p by dou x into 1 upon density plus mu upon density is equals to dou square u upon dou y square is equals to 0. Then we'll put divide by density, then we'll put this part as 0. Well, let us take this on the other side. So we'll get this as kinematic viscosity into dou square u upon dou y square is equals to 1 upon rho into dou p by dou x. So that is what the equation we get. Now we know that kinematic viscosity is the ratio of viscosity of the fluid to its density. So we have got an equation of u in terms of this entire part. Now let us understand this entirely. Now over here, this term dou p by dou x will be a constant. Why it will be a constant? Because this is the change in pressure along x direction. Now this change in pressure will allow the fluid to flow from one end to another end in the pipe or on the entire horizontal surface. So this part should be constant, then only we can able to solve this equation. And over here, pressure is just a function of x, y, z, and t also. But over here, if we substitute the same thing, this entire thing along y direction, we'll get that along y direction and z direction, we'll get the three parts will be 0. So let us check this out. From the previous section. So we have seen this in the previous section, where this is the solution of Navier-Stokes equation. Now, in our condition, we know that V is equals to 0. Let us write down over here. That is V equals to 0, W equals to 0, dou W by dou Z is equals to 0, dou U by dou X is also equals to 0. So all these conditions we have. And for steady flow, dou V by dou T and dou W by dou T is also equals to 0. So all these conditions we have seen previously. So in this part, when we are going to substitute, over here V is 0 entirely, and over here V is also 0 entirely. Body force we do not consider. W is 0 and this is also 0. That means dou P by dou Y is equals to 0, and dou P by dou Z is also equals to 0. So in this section where we talked about a pressure which is a function of x, y, z, it is no longer a function of y because v is equals to 0. It is no longer a function of z because w is equals to 0. So if it is no longer a function of y and z, then we can write this equation, that is nu into do square u upon do y square is equals to 1 upon rho dp by dx. Dp by dx, we can replace the partial derivative by a complete derivative, and this part will be constant. The pressure over the entire pressure, the gradient rather, is constant over here. Now let us solve this equation. So let us multiply to the other side. So what do we get this as? Do square u upon do square y is equals to 1 upon a rho into nu into do p by do x. So we have to integrate this with respect to y. So if you write this, this is a nu upon rho, rho and rho will go away, and we can write this equation do square u upon do y square is 1 upon mu into do p by do x. So the density has gone away. So now let us integrate this part with respect to y. If we integrate this part, then what do we get over here? Do u by do x is equals to, that is 1 upon u do p, we have replaced this p, do p by do x, by dp by dx. So let us write down this as dp by dx into y plus a constant c. Again, if we differentiate with respect to y, now this is not with respect to x, we'll differentiate this with respect to y. So this is equals to, we are differentiating with respect to y, so this will be equals to, u will be equals to 1 upon mu do p by do x into y square by 2 plus c1y plus c2. So this, let us consider this as c1. So now if we have got, that is u as a function of y, this is the exact solution of Navier-Stokes equation if it is going in the horizontal direction, and all the conditions also we have applied, that is v is equals to 0, w is equals to 0, do w by do z, do x is equals to 0, then do u by do x is equals to 0, and do u by do t is equals to 0. This is due to steady flow, this is due to the application of continuity equation, this is our assumption that it is infinitely long along z direction, and this is do z and this is do u, and the change in velocity along x direction, along z direction will be 0. V and w, because it is horizontal, going in the horizontal direction. So in short, let me write this all over again. You have got u just as a function of y, that is equals to, u is equals to 1 upon mu do p by do x into y square by 2 plus c1y plus c2. So we have got the equation of Navier-Stokes equation. So we have got over here u as a function of y, it is not a function of x, as well as we have seen all the other conditions. So I think, I hope you have understood how to derive an exact solution of Navier-Stokes equation considering all the following conditions. First, it is a steady flow, then we apply a continuity equation, then we put do u by do z is equals to 0, considering it is an infinitely long fluid along y direction, and it does not have any gradient along z direction, and v and w is equals to 0. By considering all these conditions in the differential equation, you get the solution, that is u as a function of y, but you can see over here it is a quadratic equation which we have evaluated over here. So I hope you have understood how to calculate the exact solution of Navier-Stokes equation. Thank you.